Sister Radhika is a postgraduate in psychology and has dedicated her life to the services of Brahma Kumaris since over 20 years. Is also regular faculty for the Brahma Kumari's business industry wing. So can we hear a round of applause for Sister Radhika? Thank you. And Sister Radhika also is she creates modules for and written two books. You would see some of the books there. They say that God, any inauguration, any beginning is always in the remembrance of God. So before we actually experience silence in a
Sanita Ben mentioned to you all how we thought about today to gather and to share and to experience meditation. Though it's a working day, you know, usually we have these sessions on Sundays or Saturdays, but today we thought we should have it on the day which is celebrated all over the world as International Day of Yoga. Yoga means connection. Usually when they're getting a girl or a boy married, and they try to match their horoscope, when it does not match, they say, yoga theek nahi hai. Which means to say there is no connection. The connection is not good. There are certain numbers that you have to have before you can gel well with each other. So they say, you know, yoga theek nahi. Like you're all sitting here and I'm speaking. If you are listening to me with attention and you're not thinking of anything else, that means to say you have yoga with me. You could connect to what I'm speaking. You're able to relate to what I'm speaking. So there are two levels of connections. One would be physical. You're connecting to the person, like you can meet that person and introduce yourself and say, I'm so and so and this is my background, this is my education, I've come from here. So that is still not the kind of connection that you know that person very well. You would say, yes, yes, I've met him. But do you know him? I say, no, I don't know. How would you know him? You would know him when you start connecting from another level. That is, you know their qualities, you know their traits, you know their feelings, you know how they are. That is another level. So there are a lot of people who seek for much more deeper connection. They'd say, you know, even if I know the person and everything and all that, but what I feel and what the other person feels should match. That is very difficult. Unless I'm not connecting to myself, and this is a spiritual connection. To have a very deep relationship with myself and a very deep relationship with God, because these two connections you cannot see. This is something you can experience. So, till that is not there, any connection you have with anything, whether it's work, whether it's people, whether it's a task, whether it's a job, whatever, you will feel, you know, for a moment that you achieved something, but you can't sustain that success. You can't sustain a good feeling. You can't sustain good thoughts. You can't sustain good feelings. Very difficult. Very, very difficult. You will have a good feeling. In Hindi, they use the word prasanna. You feel pleased with things, but you can't sustain it. That is where the power of silence comes into the picture. Let us experiment right now. The first normal level, the physical level. I would want you to turn to the person next to you and introduce each other. Do you know each other? Just turn to the person next to you. Do you know this person? Do you know? How many of you all know the person who's sitting next to you? Please go and sit somewhere else. Or go and meet somebody. Turn back. Turn around back and see who's sitting behind you. If you are sitting next to a person you already know, please turn back. And then introduce each other. Who are you? Where did you come from? Go ahead. What is your name? Where do you come from? Don't go into any more details. That is enough. That's more than enough. It's over. That means you, if you see this person somewhere, you would smile, no? Right or wrong? It is required that you smile. It's rude if you don't, because you've already met each other. Now we go to the next level. Share with each other something in your life that you're very proud about. You're very proud of yourself. That you think, see, nobody could do it, I could do it. You know, something I'm very proud. It could be anything. It could be helping someone. It could be, you know, overcoming some obstacle in your own life. It could be anything. Turn around and see that they understand your language. And then you share. Go ahead. Something you're proud about. That you feel good about yourself. If there's a quality that is very good in yourself. Anything. Go ahead. Why is some not at all talking to others? You should turn around, no? Turn around, sit, who's sitting there? Okay, finish. You could share what you're proud about. Don't tell a whole story. Little bit, briefly. They feel comfortable. Yeah. I can see a lot of smiling faces. Okay. So you liked sharing what you're proud about? Yeah? Okay. Now we come to the spiritual aspect. In just silence, it took about 2 to 3 minutes to know their name, 2 to 3 minutes to know what they are about, and what kind of a person this person is. I mean, you can't know them entirely. Maybe tip of an iceberg, you came to know this individual that is there. But we go to the spiritual level. The spiritual level, you don't need sound. You don't need to talk. You don't need to express. You know, to contribute to that individual. Of course, you know, that doesn't mean if you're spiritual, you won't talk, you won't do anything. I'm not saying that. But if you want to really do something with another individual, you don't have to know much. You will start contributing. Because you will understand whoever it is, whatever they are, wherever they come from, they're all beautiful beings. They're really beautiful beings. Whether it's your relative, whether it's your friend, whether you don't even know this person, with a whole bunch of weaknesses, but yet, they're very beautiful beings. To be aware of that all the time, and I'm able to understand that others are beautiful beings because I am. If this awareness and the awareness of others is there, you'll be ready for the real spiritual experience. Okay? First, become aware that you are a diamond. Not a physical diamond, but a spiritual diamond. See, if you go to a house, the two boards are there, engraved. Some people will engrave and keep one, the name of the house. No? Some Shanti Nilayam, some Nilayam, something. They'll have the name there. The other side, there'll be the name of the person who lives inside that house. Mr. and Mrs. so-and-so, so-and-so, so. Right? Two names you will find. For each one of us also, there are two names. One, the way you meet the other person, that is very limited. You really don't know much about them. But there is some part of you, there's a whole part of you, which others don't know. Can I really know what you're thinking right now? Okay, fine. Can you make out what I am thinking? Do you know what I'm thinking? No. Sure you can, you know? No, you can't. Do you know how the person next to you were speaking to feels? No, they're all hidden. What can you see? The house. You can see the house, but you can't see the owner. No, the owner will be inside the house, isn't it? Until unless he decides to come out and say, okay, hello, how are you? But he is not visible. You can only see the names there and the owner hidden inside the house. So are you, this body is a house for the diamond. And the diamond is you. So this particular body is a house for the diamond that you are. If you were to go to the owner of the house and say, hello there, Shanti Nilayam, how are you? What will he say? What you're talking? Shanti Nilayam is the name of my house. I am Rama Rao. Right? My name is not Shanti Nilayam. Right? He knows who he is. But the problem here is that we live thinking that we are houses. See, how do you know this is a house and it is not me? Because if someone dies and the body is kept there, even if that body belongs to someone whom you love a lot, they tell you keep the body in your house for 2 months, would you keep? I say, you love this person so much, Front room in the living room, they will keep it. What is that? Preservatives and all, whatever. Chemicals will keep. What is that? No, it's not good. No, it's good. It's not good, one thing. You'll be scared, no? Won't you be scared? In the house, people will be scared. Even if the person you love the most died and suddenly you see that person walking in, what will happen? You will be scared like anything and run. You would not say, oh, my relative, so much love, I have come back. You've come back? No. You'd be scared, no? Same way. Like how if a building is there and people have not been living it for a long time and there's all cobwebs everywhere and you have to live there, what you will feel? What do they call it? Booth bungala. They say, no, we don't want to. In everything you feel, the booth is coming. Anything empty is scary. So the body is empty of what? That you're scared? Empty of the diamond. The soul, the energy, the being. If the soul is powerful, if the soul is energized, if the soul is capable, then what happens is that the body functions very nicely. Even if it does not function nicely, you are not affected by it. Even if situations don't function properly, you don't feel much. It's okay, no problem. I'll do something about it. You're calmer, you're cooler, you don't think too much. We are all originally spiritual beings who's taking care of a physical body. You don't have a spiritual being. You are a spiritual being. Without that understanding, you cannot experience silence. Because body means sound. You think you're a body, so you say, I'm so good, I'm so... Why, what happened? Why did this happen? So many thoughts come when you think that you're a body. Connecting to the body, there's so many people, there's so many relatives, there's so many tasks, there's so much expectation. So many things come into the picture the minute you think you're a body. So, let us now remind ourselves that we are spiritual beings. Now in silence, to this person you spoke to, you think about this person next to you and you wish whoever this person is, whatever life journey they're going through, whatever situations they have, I wish them a lot of strength. I wish them success. I wish them peace. Can we think that now? This is called spiritual connection. You don't have to tell, you don't know what you're thinking will reach them. It will reach them. That's why they say, no, a lot of people call me, sister, my surgery, please meditate for me. Sister, my children are getting married, please send your good wishes. There is so much impact about good wishes, so much impact is there. Shall we try that? We don't only have to go to a wedding and take rice and throw on somebody and then say, okay, now good wishes are given. No. We can give it sitting here, no? To anybody in anywhere. Shall we try? Okay. We can put some music if it is there. If it's not, it's okay. And gently remind yourself. I am a being of light behind my forehead. And I'm constantly thinking, feeling, understanding, knowing, independent of this body. I'm a spark of light. And the one who's sitting next to me, the one I'm interacted with, is also a spiritual being, just a point of light in his or her body. In the energy that they are eternal. Originally, beautiful qualities of love, peace and happiness. And from the depth of my heart, I wish them strength. I wish them peace and happiness. I wish them power to face situations. Thank you. You could do it? You could do it? Yes or no? Yes. Was it difficult? Huh? Your mind was wandering and you could not concentrate. It was like that? You could do it a little bit? Meditation over. What else you want to do now? It's as simple as that. Do you feel good doing it? You feel good doing it because you're a spiritual being. Somebody had come to the center and he was saying, "Sister, my brother went to see a girl, taking his son, for a son alliance. I'm 15 years older than him. I'm the oldest in the family. Our parents are not there. I am the oldest. And through my cousin, I came to know that he went to see a girl for his son without telling." That means, what is the purpose of a relationship? He doesn't want me to come? I won't go, but at least you can inform I'm going. Does he not want my good wishes? Does he not want my good feelings? He went on and on. And he's feeling so bad, he got tears in his eyes. And his wife is telling, "Leave, when they are not able to do good for us, leave them. We'll forget about them." Like that she's telling. How he'll forget is a brother, no. So I'm feeling very bad, sister. And I said, "You know, now if you tell him now, you call him up and tell him why you did this and you did not call me, it'll create more distance. Lot of problems, and he'll not like how you're demanding. He'll feel you're demanding, and he'll feel, I want to do my own thing. Why are you interfering?" Like that he will feel. If he has that regard and respect, he would have called you. Maybe he'll call you tomorrow. He might call you day after and inform you. He says, "Sister, I don't think so. Because I spoke to him twice about some transaction and he didn't even mention." I said, "If he doesn't have it, then you should be able to do something. You should be able to do something that will make him feel that he should talk to you." He said, "Sister, what do you want me to do? Should I tell my cousin to go and tell him? You should involve your older brother." I said, "No, that would not be good because your cousin also may not agree to that. You know what you should do? You should send good wishes." He said, "What, sister, what good wishes after what he did to me?" I said, no. "The alliance should be good. The boy should get a good girl. They should be happy. Things should be fine. Because being the oldest in the family, this is what everybody would expect you to do, and that is why they call you. Just because you're older, you're sitting there, doesn't matter. You wish well. And your wishes will work much more strongly than anything else. So can you do it? Can you send this message across to him?" He said, "Okay, that means I will, even for the wedding he may not invite." I said, "No, don't come to conclusions like that. Just send good wishes. You came to know the information because God wanted you to know so that you can send these wishes. Do it." His wife said, yes, that is very good. Or else why talking and arguing? So even. He's sending that they should do well because he has a lot of love for his nephew also. So, send good wishes. He's going on thinking and wishing them well. Then what happened? Somebody reminded the other brother, now I think the alliance is getting fixed. You should involve your other two brothers, no? You should call them this and that. They said, no, not now yet. I will not tell. First, let everything be fixed. And then we will do. So when he came to know, again he told me, see sister, he doesn't want to be involved. He thinks, you know, I will spoil the alliance. How will I spoil it? I said, see, you're giving good wishes. Now you connect to God. Do something that I can go in now. He said, no, really? Do you think I can? Yeah, tell God. God, now I want to be there. I want to contribute. I want to do something there. Please take me there. You tell. He said, sister, all these things, will it work, sister? I said, these are the only practical things now which will work. So he went on telling God, you do. Whatever you want me to do, I am there. I am instrument, you do something. What happened? Just 3 days later, that girl's family, they said, you know, we will have another ceremony before engagement. And actually, we wanted this alliance. We want to tell you, we wanted this alliance because of your older brother. We've heard a lot about him. We have great respect for him because my family members have taken a lot of benefit from your elder brother. So when we have this transaction, we would want him to be present. They called him. You get what I'm trying to say? You know, there are many methods. And then the brother comes up to him and he's telling, Anna, I want to do everything and completely do everything and then tell you actually, but I have to tell you now only. So I'm surprised. Why you could not tell before? No, I wanted to show you that I can do at least one thing on my own. Every time you tell, you can't do anything on your own. I wanted to do something on my own and show you. So his intention is not bad. You get what I'm trying to say? So what we are thinking, what we are feeling is reaching people. If you keep on looking at somebody, I don't like this person, that person will somehow not like you. Surely will start disliking you. They'll be sitting and minding their business, but you're thinking, look at this, it's so bad person. Then that person will look at it, she's a bad person. Spirituality is to introduce silence within in such a way that I don't have to judge anybody. Judgment is too much sound. Too much sound it is, judging everything. Some people have too much likes and dislikes. I don't like this, I don't like that, I don't like, why he did this, why he did that, why? He didn't smile, I'm getting out of here. One boy got married, just 2 months, went to the girl's family, and he's telling, oh, they didn't get up when I walked in. Hare Baba, what do you want me to get up? And they gave tea which was not very hot. What is all this? Huh? What is, why so much respect, what do you want? Because you are not respecting yourself. Self-worth. Spirituality is self-worth. You won't feel so insecure and hurt and sensitive so easily in every time. That is shallowness, no? We'll do another exercise. To be able to wish well, and most importantly, I have to wish well for myself. And wish well for myself, not because, you know, something wrong is going to happen. No. I wish well because I understand that I'm originally a very beautiful, very, very, very pure being. Do you love purity? Do you love happiness? Do you love love? Yeah? Yes? Do you love contentment? Huh? Do you like commitment? Do you like people who are very responsible? Yes or no? Huh? If somebody is giving you happiness, you'll say, no, Papa, I'm so bored with happiness. Would you say that? Never. Why? That is who you are. Because you can connect with it. You can connect with it. That is what you are originally. Have you seen a perfect relationship? in your life? Not stories and movies, but have you, with your eyes, and experienced a perfect relationship? Have you? Honestly, no, we haven't. I mean, there's a perfect way of dealing with them, but we haven't seen a perfect relationship. Have you seen a perfect human being? I mean, there are certain things we get inspired from people. We think he's great and all, but perfect. Perfect means nobody should say anything bad about that person. Have you seen anybody like that? Perfect, like perfect. But if I ask you, please give a lecture on perfect relationship, won't you? Yeah? You will. Can you talk about a perfect human being, how they should be? You will. For every person, you will have one particular principle on which they should live. The other day, somebody was telling me, sister, nothing that person has to do, nothing he has to do. Little bit considerate, little bit concern, little bit helping nature, little bit. How much? That's all. If all these qualities are there, there's nothing we need from this. That's all I'm asking for. That's all means that's a lot. That's a lot. But we can talk and talk and talk. Why? I've never had it, but I know it because originally that is who I am. That is originally what I am. Anything which you are not, you will feel uncomfortable. You get angry, jealous, irritated, stubborn, and then say, wow, what a good feeling. Every day, little bit anger, little bit jealousy is very necessary. Would you think that? Have you ever thought like that? Because anger, irritation, jealousy brings so much sound in the mind. So many thoughts. Very difficult to be happy in that. All the thoughts. It is necessary to be spiritual. It's necessary now. It's not a choice. Because the more you are in the physical realm of thinking and living, it's bothersome after a while. You get bored with the great things that you enjoy after a while. I know somebody who worked so hard, got into IIT, got into IIM, try hard. Got into that IBS, everything he's doing, very, very intelligent. He's got so much site specs also. And he's a Bengali boy. So many alliances are coming. And he's saying, oh my God, I'm too busy. I can't marry now. Okay. Parents are saying, no, marry. So one day we had, he had some program and he'd come. And he's come to me. First he spoke to Praveena Ben. Then Praveena Ben said, something odd about this boy. So what is odd? So you should talk and see what is odd. I sat with him and said, that's pleasant to meet you, pleasant to talk to, and it's very nice and all that, he's telling me. And then he's telling, there are certain things I don't believe. I said, of course, I mean, in some principles, something, what you don't believe? No, I don't believe in, if you're calling me brother, I don't like it. I said, okay, I'll call you with your name. What's your name? Amok. I said, Amok, where, how are you? And then I do not like anybody to think I'm their brother. I said, okay, fine. Who is thinking you're a brother? No, anybody for that matter. I have a sister, that's all I want. I don't want anybody else. That's all. I'm having sleepless nights and I'm having difficulty. It's just because of this aspect, it seems. How can that be such a troublesome thing for you? You are so educated, you IIT, IIM, IBS, or ISB, whatever. What is your problem if you, only your sister should call you bhaiya? If somebody is still like, bhaiya, time kya hua, you will get irritated. No, sister, I don't want. He's calling me sister. And then he doesn't want to be called a brother. I don't understand his nature. Then I told him, tell me, what is your problem? He's saying, look, there is one person I want to marry. Finally. Okay. Marry. No, that is a problem, no, sister. What is your problem? She is my mother's sister's daughter. I said, how you will marry? Your Masi's daughter, you should not. What is the shoulds? Who told you the should? She's asking me. No, we should not think also like that, brother. That is wrong. That she's a sister. No, don't say that word. Meaning the thing is, what has happened with all this education, achievements, accomplishment? I'm not saying every person is IITM is going like that. I'm telling you, it didn't evolve. He hasn't understood that there are certain rules. You just can't live the way you want just because you're intelligent. You can't go on, you know, refusing and challenging everything which is already established. You can't do that. He's purposely, you know, arrogantly talking that, no, I don't think so, I don't believe it. So he called that girl in front of me, you know, and he's talking to her. Hello. She's saying, ha, dada, tum mereko dada ne bolo. Dada means brother in Bengali. Ha, dada, naturally she'll say dada. No, she's saying, don't call me, he's telling. I said, brother, you need spirituality. You require it. You've educated yourself in every physical level. You know all physics, chemistry, don't know what you know. But you haven't understood the basic thing, basic principles of life. You haven't understood. Which is not at all difficult for a lot of people. They won't even think like that about their sister. You have no consciousness only. I don't feel guilty. I'm giving you a guarantee I'll marry her, it seems. That girl, I took the phone and I said, tell me what's going on, sister. I'm so scared. I want to tell my parents. I said, please tell your parents. Immediately, I told. And he's telling me, how you're telling her like that? I said, I will tell. Let her go. She will get frustration. She will go, you know, she'll go into depression. How this brother is like that, so terrible. You get what I'm trying to say? The other day I went to one company and there that brother kept on telling me so many thoughts that he's having, which is so wrong. And nobody knows it. Nobody really knows it. But he's suffering it. And that's exactly why I have to empower myself, because originally my qualities are beautiful, no? If I charge, those qualities will come up. Now what is happening, only what in the physical level all those qualities are working, which is discharging me to such an extent that my originality is not coming out. I don't feel comfortable. If someone were to come up and say, you are the best person in the world, what will you say? I don't talk. Won't you say that? You are the best person. I feel you're the wonderful person. I may be wonderful and all, but no, I'm not the best. You would say that. No, I'm not the best. Spirituality makes you feel that originally you're beautiful, but you've acquired some weaknesses too. Two things you will know, because there is no scope for ego, there's only scope for self-respect. Who can bring out these virtues out, these qualities out, is only God. I am a spiritual being, and God would be physical being. What do you feel? He's a physical being, is it? 2 hands, 13 feet, 12 hands, maybe 3 heads. Because he's God. He's also a spiritual being. Whenever somebody was telling, sister, whenever I talk to God, I'll always talk good things. When I talk to people, I talk bad things. Why like that? Because he is very good, no? That's why he's asking. But please give everybody happiness, everybody should be fine, I should be fine. But really when I come into interaction, I treat my wife so bad. There's no strength inside, no? Somebody was telling me, the wife, she was telling me, sister, ask my husband what question I ask him when he comes home. And I get very irritated. Then he gets very irritated. I said, why do you ask that question at all? Sister, please ask him. Right in front of him only. I asked, brother, why? What is that question she asks you? As soon as you come home. He smiled. And he said, sister, she asked me, how was your day? What answer should come out of your mouth? Good, bad, ugly, dirty, whatever. One word is enough? Okay, not bad. Fine. Why 5 sentences of irritation? You have to ask right now. Can't you just leave me alone? Just that. Why? I can't connect to somebody from a pure level. I'm not able to. It's all about the past. This is impurity. Past is impurity. That is not me. I don't live there. Ghosts live there. Then I'm thinking 2 years ago it is, 3 years ago it is. About 5 years ago, sister, my brother did this. Somebody was telling me, care hospital, brother is admitted, should I go? He's admitted, you should go. Why are you asking me, brother? You should go, no. He's telling, no, sister, you understand. We've not been talking since 20 years now. Why you're not talking, brother? I don't remember, sister, now. It's been so long. Just not in touch, that's it. Years together. We'll do an experiment now. Bring all those people that you're not able to get along with. Get along means you find them a little difficult. You get very agitated with them. Rest of the people, you're okay. But with that person, that group of people, lot of irritation. And there are some people, you take a lot of sorrow from them. You feel so bad. My God, when will this person change? Why? What will happen? There's so much. And there's some people who have a lot of fear. They'll say something, they'll do something, they might do this. And then. And there are some people, you're not even talking to them. You don't want to deal with them, you don't want to see them. You're not able to forgive them. All types of varieties of people are there. One person or other, some of them can be very close to you. Some of them far out, sometimes somewhere else. Bring them all in front of you today. Spirituality is to bring silence in relationships. We are able to bring a vision which is just pure. It is not about them anymore. It's about me. I want to start off nice. I don't want all this, like I remember when we would do some homework or something in school, I used to have a friend sitting next to me. My God, she would just tear pages. So what are you doing? No, it's not come out. She'll tear and again start writing. And then she'll tear. So why? No, it's not come perfect. I want to start fresh from the beginning till the end. Nice handwriting should be there. So it went off wrong, so I'll do it again. Lot of patience she had. I said, forget it. I'll write what the way I want. I used to think. She used to always tear pages and nicely she'll write. Like that we should be. Tear the page. Write neatly. When you look back, you will feel, that was very good. Anybody you would meet in any get-together, you should not feel uncomfortable. Any person you remember from anything in the past, you should not feel uncomfortable. Because it will start affecting your health, it will start affecting your mind. The other day somebody said, sister, one person rejected me, sister. Then I thought, okay, but after 4 years, I'm seeing that I am getting a lot of sleeplessness and everything, a lot of problems. The doctor is saying, did anything affect you a few years ago? He said, yes. So the rejection is not resolved, so now you're going through mental problems. You get what I'm trying to say? Who wants mental problems? You tell me now. We have enough problems out there. Shall we try that now? Again, soul, and see them as souls. Don't see the bodies. If you see the bodies, you'll remember all the relationship, the incidents, what they did, what they spoke, all that you'll remember. Don't see that. Be an observer. See them as a soul, sparkling, beautiful, and then give good wishes. Shall we try that now? Shall we? Sit back, relax yourself. I'll give you thoughts. Some music, please. I remind myself that I am a being of light, a soul. I am peace, I am love, and I'm happiness. I forgive. I understand. In front of me, I emerge though. I emerge those in the past or in the present. And I understand that they're all going through their own journey throughout my life. And I send across that they do well wherever they are. And I gently build within myself the power to accept and I hold no grudges. I hold no resentment. Just a pure feeling that they do. From a bondage. Of attitudes and judgments. Okay. To forgive, to give, to let go becomes easier. Did anybody here find it a little difficult to do that? It was easy? Was it easy or not? It was? You could do that? Yeah? You should be able to do that. To such an extent that if you were to meet them, the responses should not be the same. You get what I'm trying to say? They should not be the same response, the same taking sorrow, the same feelings, the same attitude, the same judgment. It should not be there to that extent. We need power now. We have enough knowledge. We have a lot of knowledge. We need power. But who can give us that power? Only God can, because He is a spiritual being, just like us. For the physical body, we have a father who gave birth to this body. Yes? And He will take, I mean, if you have any problem with your body, you tell Him, no? I'm the youngest now, I've got a headache, I've got a backache. I need to do something about it. I'm not able to study. I didn't get my job, I lost my job. Tell your father. But you feel bad about something, you're going through a trauma. Even young, small children, they don't go tell their father. I remember here in Umanagar, one girl, she must be eight. She's 8 years old and she's just standing there and watching me. I said, do you want this? What is it? Come. So she's coming to me and say, sister, can you give me some time, it seems. Huh? Time? You want my time for what? No, just sometime I want to talk to you. I said, I was so shocked. What she would have to talk? See, people come up and tell me, like, you know, sister, give me some time, we need to talk. And this is, from an 8-year-old, I can't expect that. I said, I was very happy though. I said, surely I will. I mean, I sat with her, so many issues at school, at home, and she's crying and telling, you know, how my mother, she does this, that. She said like this yesterday, day before yesterday. Oh, I said, look, you should tell your father and mother you're feeling like this. Huh? It's good, no? Then they will know what's happening. Sister, they won't understand, sister. So you think, by telling me how the solution will come, what do you want me to do? No, I'm telling you, you can't do anything, but I want you to tell God. But you can't listen. You talk to God now every day, sister, so He will listen to you better, it seems. you tell him that I am going through these problems, so please ask him to give me solution. So, if the soul has a problem, the soul's father has to hear it, no? And God is the father of the soul. When you sit in front of God, do you ever say, God, I came to know, I know I have backache. Will you tell God that? I have backache and I don't know, you know, maybe my back pain is there and my head pain is there. Well, hardly. God, I'm scared of this disease. I think it may come. I've given for testing. Maybe it should not be cancer. I'm scared. But feelings. Feelings is what you will share. Fear is what you will share because he is the father of the soul. The way I have two hands and two feet, and if you meet my father who gave birth to this body, he also has two hands and two feet. Would you say, sister, your father? No, he should have 16 hands and 13 feet. No. Two hands and two feet only he has. And I look so much like him. So, the owner of this body is, who is? Who is the owner of this body? The soul, that is me. That is me. And this is my body in which I am sitting and I am talking. I am the soul, the owner of the body called Radhika. Make sense? I am not an angry person. People say, I'm very angry, sister. I tell them, no, you don't say that. You should say, I'm a peaceful being who's acquired a trait of anger. You can get rid of it, no? So, God is eternally peaceful, eternally loving, and he's supreme soul. He's only the soul and he has no body. The difference between me and him is that he has no body. So, I need to connect to him. I can connect to him only through thoughts and feelings and through my intellect. I can't connect with, you know, just going and talking like how you can talk to people. You can talk to him, but from here. You don't have to stand under the sky and say, God, where are you? Please help me. It doesn't work like that. Wherever you are, why you mean wherever you are? When you say God, where do you see? Where do you see when you say God? Down? Below? Side? Where? Mirror? I am God. You'll think? Do you ever say? If somebody comes up to you and says, you are God, then what you will say? What are you talking? There was a couple, I went to Australia once, and so I gave them the course, and then I left to Australia where I said, you know, I'll be back after 1 month, so you come every day and, you know, meditate in the center. It'll be very nice. You should be regular. Okay, they said, but when I came back, I came to know, they never came even one day. So when they came to know I'm back, they came back. Hey, sister, we missed you. I said, what is missing me? I told you to come every day, no? And meditate. Yes, sister. So you should talk to God, sit. I don't know God and all, sister. After taking all the course and everything, they're saying, I don't know who God is and everything, but you are only God for us. I said, you will not get any strength, both of you, nothing will get. I am only taking strength from him. What strength I will give you? I will tell you how to take strength, no? Any human being for that matter, they can guide you, they can tell you this is right and wrong, they can give you some preaching, some teaching, something. They might even inculcate in their life and show this is how you should do. Strength nobody can give. Strength is what the soul requires now. And strength can be given only by the father of the soul. So if I tell you, God is in Panjagutta, what will you say? What is this? There is something. Let's go from here, you will say. Right? Huh? Okay, fine. You don't believe that he's in Panjagutta. He's in Mumbai. You will say, no way, that is not possible. How God can be here? Some people say, everywhere is God. No, God is not everywhere. It is fear, to create fear. They said he is watching you. Don't make mistakes. Huh? When you say God, where do you see? Above? Beyond? God, you are up there. Upper wale jane. Meedunna vada delsu. Meedunna vada middhi meedha gaadu. Where? beyond the universe, beyond our limitations, he is there. He is also a point of light, just like me. Like Muslims say, Khuda Noor hai. Christians say, God is light. In Gita is written, Jyoti Bindu Paramatma. Light and light. If you go to Chidambaram, there's one beautiful temple. There if you go, when I went as a, I must have been third or fourth class, I don't know which class. I went there. And when I went there was a room locked. They said, Chidambar Rahasyam. There's a secret in there. I said, what secret is there? No, we will not open some one day. In those days, they would open in one particular day. My vacation was getting over. So I told my father, who was working there, I told him, you know what you have to do? Before you come back to Hyderabad, I want you to see what is inside that and come and tell me. My father is least interested in that. So that day, I remember I called. At that time, no mobile phones, nothing. I called him from phone and said, please, did you go and find out you are coming back day after? Go and see. My father is telling, no, I have no time. I said, please, you go. And he said, okay, I'll tell my student to go. So he sent some students. They went and saw and came. So they only called me. In half Tamil, half English, they told me that there is nothing inside there. When you open that door, there is pitch darkness and there's a small little light flickering in the corner. And they said, this is a secret of God. This is how God really looks like. And they closed the door. Finished, over. God is just a point of light. And God is a point of light, but immensely powerful. And his children are all points of lights. Some may be in Christianity, some may be Islam, some may be in American, some may be Chinese. But all are his children. Whether they are divine, whether they are Punyatma, Dharmatma, Mahatma, all of them are his children. So, today we will talk to him now. The next exercise is, I am a soul and I'm remembering him and I'm talking to him. Make it very, very informal. Don't make it formal. Hey, Prabhu, hey, Ishwar. How it is if your father is prime minister and you go and say, can I have appointment? Eh? What will people say? Hare, he's your father. What kind of person you are? You go inside and talk. Do you need a secretary? Do you need somebody in between? I'll take you to God. Nowadays, what is happening? There are some good people, but some people will say, okay, I'll take you to God, and suddenly he'll say, I'm only God. You're in trouble, no? Really trouble. One person was telling, sister, I spent so much money. I said, what money? How much? He said she and her husband are saying, 1 foot, one person will put it, seem like that. If you touch that, 25,000 rupees. If you touch this, say another 25,000. Both 50,000. Touching the feet of that person who's said to be a secretary for God. That is not right, na? Right? God does not have feet. This is reality. He has no feet. He's nirakar. When Arjuna had the sakshatkar, the vision, he only saw light. Just pure bright light. In Prophet Muhammad went on the mountain, he had a vision of God. He's only light. Jesus Christ said, he is God, is light. Guru Nanak said, Eko Omkar Satanam Akal. He just cannot have death. He never experiences death. He has no body. He's only one. He told. All the ones who are so great souls have already told his light, and then we are here sitting. You show one leg, you show another leg, and I will touch it. One brother came and told me, sister, I have so many problems, sister, I went to this person and I don't want to take your meditation course because maybe my, what had happened to my family, it will happen to me. I said, what happened? He said, his brother, I felt very bad, let me tell you. His brother went to somebody, I don't know the names, I don't want to mention the names, went there and don't know what happened. He, his wife, his children, all committed suicide. Why? Because he wrote a letter that our Guruji has told us that if you died this today, at this time at 7:30 in the PM, you will go to Swarg. So better go straight to God, now. Huh? Some are good, some are bad, whom we know, what we know. You know nothing. Better we go straight to. It is a time, now time has come for that. Who is he? I know. Where is he? I know. Better connect with Buddhi. And with all our due respects for everyone. Because you don't know what is happening, because the times are getting more worse, no? You hear of these news of everything that is happening, not only for myself, but also for the world. I need to charge myself. That I feel good, so that I can, if people come in connection with me, they should feel good. Not just for myself. Somebody was telling, sister, I don't know now of my children in the future, will I be able to see them struggle? And now only I'm getting so worked up. To see them go, study, get a job, this, my God, it's so much tension, sister, I'm having to see what the world they live in. It's getting worse. I was in a better place, I feel, he's telling. So not only for myself, for my children, for the people around me, for my brothers, my sisters, people who have been, you know, killed and going through so much trauma, for everybody. We have to become strong. See, when somebody sent a small video in Facebook, he's, you know, drowning someplace, somewhere, he's just, he caught hold of a rock and he took his hand and pulled that lady. He would slip, but no, he's holding all of that and pulling that lady, he's slipping, but he will not leave that lady. And that lady is no relative of his. They're saying, what a great man. And he caught hold of her and kept her and got her out. Some people have it in them. One boy, he saw his sister getting shot. He went in and jumped on that man so that he won't shoot at others. So, there are, that is physical level. But mentally I should be able to, if I'm only caught up, my son is not, is on the mobile phone and crying. He's on the mobile phone. There are bigger things in the world. Somebody told me, sister, I'm very worried. My son is on the mobile phone. I'm going on thinking, why you're worried? Go hide the mobile phone somewhere, no? Finish it. And so don't know where it went, you tell. That's it, no? That's all that matters. There are bigger things in the world and we have to contribute. And for that, we have to take strength from God. Shall we try that now? How to do it? Go on, sit back, relax yourself. See, when you learn how to meditate, now you don't need anybody giving you a commentary also. You don't need me, you don't need anybody. You can do it on your own. Sit back. I sit in silence again in order to build strength within me. In order to fill myself and also fill others. I don't just experience a silence around me. But I would like to experience a silence within me. And right behind my eyes is I, the spiritual being, the soul. And I'm just a point of light, divine, eternal. And I use this body like a car. I see through these eyes, I hear through these ears. I use this body, but I am the master of this body. For I am the one who's thinking, feeling, and I experience pain and pleasure. And I'm a peaceful being. and a loveful being. Powerful being. And I ask myself, who am I? And I give myself an answer. I am a soul sitting inside this body. Whom do I belong to? Beyond this earth, beyond the universe, beyond all limitations. In a land of light and silence is God. He is also a spark of energy, immensely powerful, almighty authority. Who is he to me? He is my father, mother, friend. He has all the strength and love that he can fill me. And he knows me more than I can ever know myself. He is my true parent. And his rays of purity and power penetrate through the universe and through the clouds and skies and reach out here to me, filling me, the soul, charging me. So that I can experience my original qualities of love, compassion, mercy, strength. And I'm gently I'm able to send it across to the whole world, to all the souls who are suffering, whether they're in hospitals, where they're suffering the death of a relative, they're going through a trauma of their own situations. Who are going through sorrow because of relationships, through natural calamities. Sending across peace, sending across power, which I take from God, and I reach out to everyone around the world. I wish them well, I wish them strength, and I wish God's protection and power. These good intentions will travel and give them strength. And this whole big wide world, I see my own family members, and I send across a message of love. Just a pure feeling to give, to contribute, to empower. Om Shanti. Thank you so much for listening and to experience silence with me. We can do, you know, because more often, because when there is Sangatan, they say Sangatan ki Shakti. If everyone thinks in just one thought, it happens. It just happens. No question about it. So that's why weddings, they call so many people. So they all come and wish them good. And good things should happen. So I wish you all a lot of moments of silence, that you empower yourself and the ones around you. You don't have to waste so much of your thought energy and word energy to get things done. But just with your thoughts, you can create magic. And just by remembering God, you can make impossible possible. Thank you so much for coming. Om Shanti.
Thank you, sister. I would like to ask you any questions. Anybody has any questions? Extremely content.
Yes, brother. Yes. Your mic.
How to make this consistent one?
I've been mentioning about this. A lot of people ask this question, and I have been going different places, and I've mentioned about this, that in Mumbai, I went to a gym. The owner of the gym wanted us to come and see how she's made this celebrity gym. And there I went, and I saw that 3 to 4 in the afternoon, the people who are trainers, that there is one person who trains movie actor Salman Khan. He comes in midnight and he practices there. So he is exclusively for him, the trainer. And they're very well built. And they are in front of the mirror. They're continuously doing this, like that. And they're looking at themselves and going on doing. I said, what are they doing? So I asked one of them, what are you doing? You do it every day, sister. Even one day I don't do, it's a problem. How can I teach others? I cannot. I cannot inspire my customers. I said, "Acha, so what do you do?" I said, "So much I have to pay attention to my diet and my sleep, and I keep looking at myself. Am I okay? Am I fine? Am I to? I'll do all the time, sister. So I am becoming stronger. I can climb up 6 floors without feeling pain in my legs. That much stamina I have." I said, that is fantastic. I said, now dealing with all these customers and celebrities, how you are doing? You are okay? Are you getting stressed? That stamina I don't have, he said. Same way how you're building muscles, build spiritual muscles every day. Little bit. Nice thoughts, nice. Who am I? What am I? Should look at yourself in the mirror. Who am I? What am I? Who's God? What? I have to keep on creating elevated thoughts all through the day. You have to introduce that silence moments, not by just going on top of Himalayas and sitting. You will think of all waste thoughts there. Doing whatever you're doing, wherever you are, every day, practice. And that is when it becomes natural to think like that. Like just example, if somebody is talking so ill about somebody, and you go there and say, stop talking about her. Why are we talking? Do we, you know, it's not good for us to talk bad about anybody. It's not good. The minute you say that, everybody stops talking like that, no? They will stop. They will, at least in front of you, they will not talk. No? If somebody is saying, so difficult work, I don't know how to do it. And then you go and say, we'll do it. What is there? We'll finish it. In just 1 hour, it'll be finished. Everyone will become quiet. The minute you create an elevated thought, all waste thoughts will finish. That is the thing. Everything will be all right. Everybody is good. God is there. I am there. I have to keep on creating these thoughts. Nobody can deal. So does somebody wake you up in the morning and say, oh, you're so great. You're working and earning for us. You're so great cooking for me every day. Does anybody say that? Nobody says that. We have to tell ourselves that and strengthen ourselves. Every day practice sustains. Hmm? or else there's no other way. Okay.
You.
Oh, you're welcome, brother.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you. So we will have, we have our little, yeah, brother, yes.
Sir, this is the first time I'm attending this seminar.
Achha, I just want to know how many of you all have come here first time? Raise your hand. Oh, welcome, 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 yes.
So general question, but everybody knows or not, what is life? Definition.
What is life? You all tell me, what is life? You're all living, no? What is life according to you all? In just one sentence you all tell. It's a good exercise the brother has given. What is life? Take things as they come. Okay. It's a journey, so you should enjoy it. It's not like you have to reach the destination and then enjoy. Journey only we should enjoy. Life is what? You make it. What choices you take up. What thoughts you choose. And then you make your destiny, right? Okay. Any more thoughts? To be happy. To be happy. That's a big thing. Make people happy, okay. To learn, continuously learn from everything wrong that is happening also. If every situation that occurs, learn something, what is it trying to teach me? That's very right. Any more? To be in the present. Not to get caught up in something we can do nothing about. The joy, huh? Joy that you make. Choices that you make, exactly. The choices, yes. Pardon? Give the mic. Oh, fantastic. You're getting so many answers. But here. You put that mic on, brother? Gitesh? Yeah.
Is what we think.
That's it. Life is what we think. Terrible life, terrible. Great life, great. Yes, brother. The soul is related to the nature or light. Meaning, what does the question mean?
The soul which we are having.
No, you're not having. You are a soul.
Yes.
It is. You're having a body.
Yes. It is related to nature or it is a light.
Nature means you're talking about five elements?
Yes.
The body is made of five elements. The soul is made of spiritual energy.
Means equal to light.
Not physical light. Not electronic light. The spiritual consciousness is light. You can't see it with this naked eye. You cannot. You can only experience it.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, now we will have a little ceremony. In this ceremony, what we will do, you all know, that is, you will all get a blessing card and a sweet. And today, we are giving you, brother, I'll take your questions later on. Yeah?
No, okay. I made it one, that life definition. Life is a complex of problems. Solving the problems is called life.
Okay. Simple. With the right attitude. Solving problems and dying every day, what is it? Okay, so listen. You'll be getting this card. Apart from a blessing card, you'll also get this card. There's something nice written here, which you should practice when you wake up in the morning. This is one thing that you can, don't do it like a mantra, don't keep reading it. But understand what is written. It's written here, I'm a child of God. His divine light is illuminating my path. And with every step I take forward, my life is becoming effortless, easy and successful. You take this thought because you're not alone. You're not an island. Your whole family is with you. Right? You take this thought, you will take them across. Take this every day. As soon as you wake up in the morning, you say, good morning, God, and then think this. Okay, and then the blessing card you'll all get, and also the sweet. What? Because a lot of new people have come today. Let me tell you, We give you the sweet not because it tastes good. We give you the sweet because when you eat it, you sweeten your mouth. And our good wish is that only sweet words should emerge from your mouth, now onwards. So when you go home, they should be surprised at home. Such sweet words will be coming out of your mouth now. Right? Okay? And apart from that, after we give the sweet and the blessing card, you know, when you go out, there is Brahma Bhojan. This food is not from Green Park. This is made from the center in remembrance of God and in silence. We believe what you eat is the kind of mind you will create. So we make it with a lot of good wishes and silence. Do not waste it. Eat as much as you want, but don't waste it. Okay? Thank you so much. You can all take the addresses of the different centers wherever you have come from and go for the meditation course. It's just 7 days. You know, each day 40 minutes an individual, and the course is offered free anywhere, any center, all over the city. We have about 65 centers. You can go anywhere. If you're around this area, then our centers are here. You want to personally come and talk to me or meet me, you can contact Anita Ben. She has the number and you can fix a time and you can come and meet me. Okay? I made all the announcements. Om Shanti.